Check. Okay, Smart War Games hier. Let's talk about modding John Tiller games and how to install a mod or a total conversion in a convenient way. I can't talk about all of John Tiller games because my experience limits more to squad battles and the naval campaigns. And yeah, for example, I won't cover that much the Napoleonic battles, early American musket and pipe civil war battles. They also have a big modding community from what I have seen, and there are a lot of options, graphic options, etc., installing counters. But yeah, currently I don't own those games, and so I didn't check this out. But if you're here on the page, check out definitely this resources and FAQ, and you will find a lot of sources. And let me give you an overview of what I found. For example, for the campaign games, there is in the community a well-known mod which turns the map into what you see here, into a really beautiful art style. And here on the right you see it is really a lot of games I covered. World War II games. World War II. Yeah, then I found a page called Volcano Mods, which also has a lot of mods for several games, like unit mixed everything. For example, I found my aircraft and ship portraits there for Midway and Guadalcanal. Really like them. I mean, the original is also beautiful, but I like those even more, and options always good. But there are a lot of modern campaigns, right? Yeah, a lot of options. Check it out for yourself. Next. One of the biggest sources I found, especially for squad battle games, it is also itself describing as squad battles resource site, and indeed it is. Two big things here, scenarios and graphic sound game mods. Yeah, select your game and take a look. However, there are some hidden gems here. You saw my video, I for example have installed a lot of total conversions, and some of those total conversions are not listed here. I found them here under a database of called RNX Game Mods. You can download it here. Should display download in your system language. And yeah, there is for example the Arab-Israel War, big thing. The World at War, big thing. Red Star over Europe, big thing. Long War, big thing. And also big thing, Africa at War. Yeah, check it out for yourself, and you have a lot of graphic options. There are people that offer different portraits, and if you are a fan of advanced, I guess this is ASL stands for Advanced Squad Leader, I'm not sure, but the counters might be looking like in the on the board game there. But those total conversions, they are absolutely mind-blowing. So if you own one of those games, I even purchased the games in order to play. And the main games are beautiful, but my main objective was to get those total conversions. And yeah. Okay, this year really good and good resource, and check it out. Scenarios, a lot of scenarios, campaigns, graphic mods and total conversions. And last one, for me at least, there are many more, but is this page here, Sharp End Gaming. Here I found, for example, this one scenario I started to play for the Panzer Battles demo. Tavara, free for the demo, so you can get the demo and get the scenarios free as well. And he has many other scenarios for download. Or she, they. Yeah, that's it. And about installing them. Let's say you have a total conversion of the game Vietnam. If you have your game activated, you know, after you purchase on John Tiller, you get a key and a setup file, you install it, you activate the game, you can do as many copies as you want. Simply, I recommend before you install a mod, even if it is not a big mod, do a copy. It also helps you to compare John Tiller games. It's also nice to know you can run two or three games at the same time. You can even have on the right a modded game, on the left a non-modded game, in order to have a direct comparison. But that's not what we're aiming here for. We're aiming for installing a mod without screwing your original game files up. And now, for example, you could install the Red Storm Over Europe mod. I call always, you see, this is my, this was also a copy of the Vietnam folder, and then I renamed it. Same here, these two were copies of the Soviet Afghan War folder, which I then modded and renamed. And yeah, usually the mods come either with installers or files that simply, yeah, always do a side check. Check, I simply how looks the mod folder, the modded download, and then you find stuff like map, American Marines, and you know, okay, I need to put it here and go. I noticed one problem when I used the installer of many of those total conversions mods. It didn't work out. I got errors. Not sure if it really has something to do with the installation software. Could be bad luck. So I don't want to make assumptions. But if this should happen to you, try to unpack the installer into a temporary folder and then manually copy it into your folder, into your file, into your destination install folder, game folder. Okay, one thing what I however recommend, but it depends, if you don't mind the clutter, don't do it. What I don't like is I want to get rid of the original scenarios. I don't need them, because the original scenarios I will play with the original game. My mod folder, like here, Red Storm Over Europe, only contains scenarios that are designed for Red Storm Over Europe. But first, you need to get rid of your of the original scenarios in your your copy folder. And by this, before installing the total conversion, simply input here, for example, the search window SCN, which stands for scenario. Select the first, and then the shift, you select the last, and then either you hit delete on your keyboard or simply delete here, and they are gone. You can also test this by starting the game. And everything will be empty. Yeah, and then you're ready to put in, I don't know, your Red Storm Over Europe to show. Now I have a game, a modded copy of my original Vietnam, so the original install won't get screwed up. You have a mod folder, a mod install only for your modded game, and you only have the scenarios in this mod folder that are really designed for it. Otherwise, you will have millions of scenarios all over the place. I mean, in this case, it is easy to tell because they use a naming that is rather distinctive. But in other cases, it isn't that. And it might be hard to judge which one is a modded scenario designed for the mod I've installed or which one is a default one. That's it.